So when you get here, that total part over whole. So I take 942 and I divide it by 3553. Now, give me 3 decimal places. Because when we move this to a percent, we want to keep a decimal place there. If we only had 2 decimal places, we're kind of rounding it. You can round it when you put it on your graph. But on your chart, I want to see 3 decimals. So when you get down to here, you get 0.265. Do this on your calculator with me. I don't want to hear anybody saying, I don't know how to do this. So part over whole, this is your relative frequency part. You can kind of tell which one is the larger one based on the numbers. And this one was the smaller one. Now, sometimes they ask you for angles. Did you guys ever do this with angles instead of percent? No one ever did this with angles instead of percent? Okay, so how many degrees in a circle? 360 degrees. So again, I want to know which portion of the 360 degrees 0.265 represents. So all I'm going to do is this. 0.265 times 360. 0.483 times 360. 0.206 times 360. You can round this to the nearest angle. You can round this one to an angle. It's going to be real hard for you to find like a 22.2 angle anyway. So this rounds to 95 degrees, this rounds to 174 degrees, this rounds to 74 degrees, and this rounds to 17 degrees. I don't use angles, I use the relative frequency, but there are some questions that will ask you for angles. Okay. So now, we know the proportion of your circle. Now we have to draw this on a circle, on a pie chart, they call it. This is a circle graph, a pie chart. So we start out with your circle. This is how I do it. I estimate. I divide this into quarters. How much is a quarter worth in money? How much is a quarter? 25 cents. So each one of these parts is 25%. So I look at my percentages. To get a percent, I just move this 2 decimals. Move this 2 decimals. Just keep moving them 2 decimals. And this is 4.6%. Now, when you get to your pie chart, you can round them. Altogether, I should add up to, when I add up my decimals, I should add up to 1. When I add up my percents, I should add up to 100. The problem is with your rounding. So kind of verify that those add up if you round them. So say I round this guy to 27. Let's just round him to 27. Let's round this guy to 48. Let's round this guy to 21. And this guy to 5. So add this up for me. 27, 48, 21, and 5. What do you get? What did it add up to? What did it add up to? 101. Okay. I'm supposed to only add up to 100. What happened? How come I don't add up to 100? We're rounding, but what happened? This guy rounded up, this guy rounded down, this guy rounded up, this guy rounded up. I had 3 rounded ups and 1 rounded down. Real basic. If I had 2 rounded up and 2 rounded down, I would cancel that out. I would come out to 100. But I don't exactly come out to 100 because I rounded 3 of them up and 1 of them down. Technically, your circle graph can only add up to 100. So we're going to change one of those.
You round down 26.
So we can round down 26 on that one. Let's take the one with the smallest decimal. So that had the smallest decimal. So we're going to round this guy down to 26. Good. See what we did? The circle graph has to add up to 100. This had three places where we rounded up and only one place where we rounded down. So it didn't balance right. Does it have a real effect on me here? Not really, but take the lower decimal that you did. We had a 20.6, we had a 4.6. So we had a 26.5. So you know what? That was a little closer to the midpoint. So just round that one down. So now we add up to 100. That's one of the things you always check when you see a circle graph. Sometimes graphs are deceiving. They show you this big circle graph and they have all these percentages. Add them up. They have to add up to 100. That's why they usually have one slice of the pie that says other. But sometimes they forget to put that there and their percentages don't add up to 100. So now, the easiest way to do this is to take things that are close to the 25% or the 50% and work from there. So I'm going to use this one first, associates. This has 26%. So this is 25, so a slight little bit more. I have to put the percentage and I have to put the name of this category. 26% associates. Okay, so I use this one. I noticed 48. 48 is fairly close to 50, right? So I'm going to come down here and just be a little bit short in here. So this is 48%. That's, and so I use this guy. So now I have a 21% and I have a 5%. So this is probably almost 25% in here, a little bit more. I'm a little bit extra over here. So I'm going to estimate. I'm going to say this is 5%. And I'm going to say this is 21%. Did I actually count that out or measure it somehow? No. Is it eyeball okay? Does that look like that would be 21%? Isn't it inside the 25, right? This is small. Doesn't it look like it'd be 5%? If you can't fit it in there, put it on the outside of your circle and just draw a little arrow. What I don't want to see is 26% being smaller than 25. That's what I'm looking for. Just eyeball it and get in the ballpark. If you did an angle, the angles work the same way. This is a 90 degrees for a quarter. So a little bit more than 90 degrees would be my 95. A little bit less than 180 would be my 174. I find angles harder to work with than percents. And most people in the business world don't want an angle. They want a percent. They want to see percentages. What percent of this population is getting as high as a doctoral? Not a lot. Not a lot. This shows me not a lot. The biggest percentage, bachelor's. Okay, associates, a little bit better than a master's, but I could see they're kind of close. So it gives me a good scenario here. If the numbers change, then my percentages are going to change. And if my totals change, my percentages will change. And this needs a title. So this is the number of degrees, conferred. 2011. 5%. So does it sound reasonable? You've done these before, haven't you? Done circles? Yeah, a little bit. Eighth grade at least. Probably ninth grade and algebra one. Way back in the day, huh? Now that you guys are all seniors. So you're going to add the total, you're going to find your relative frequency, you're going to move them to percentages, and before you make your final circle, you're going to make sure that they add up to 100. Because some cases they don't. And we want our graph to be correct, politically correct. All right, so you guys are going to try the next one. Try it one, try it four. They gave you a set of numbers. It is on page 58. So if you guys are going to try that, the one on page 58. So let's take a look at what you have. And it is. It's sometimes awkward to have to change it, but you want them to add up to 100. You don't want your graph to be off. So what's the total of this? 1940. So we did 455 over 1940. 1940. This will give us 0.235. 1051 over 1940. This will give us 0.542. 330.
0.054. I got 0.234, 0.541, 0.170, and 0.452.
Okay, you're so different. Did they add up to 1940 for you?
Well, yeah, I had to change. Like the first one I had to.
Okay, I didn't change anything yet. I didn't change anything.
Because the first one I had to change to 0.235, but that's after.
Okay, but just right now, we didn't change them yet.
Right now, we didn't change them yet.
Yes. And I got 235. You got 234?
Yes.
Because you get this. 2345. If you round to here, look to this guy. This is forcing you to round up right there. Don't take just the first three numbers. Round to the first three numbers. Right, Jake?
Yeah.
They got to round to the first three numbers. So now, this will give us 23.5 or 24. This will give us 54.2 or 54. This will give us 17. And this will give us 5.4 or 5. So add up 24 plus 54 plus 17 plus 5. Does it come out to 100? Okay. So if you notice here, look what happened. This guy we rounded up. This guy we rounded down. This guy we rounded down. So it sometimes works out, and this one we didn't have to round. Sometimes it works out, sometimes you just might have to make an adjustment.
Even with the rounding, you think it worked out the same?
It worked out the same? Okay, that was
I
perfect.
I used a wrong number. I used
1946?
Yeah.
Yes. And that's okay. Like, so when you do this, I would just go by what you did, but the process is probably fine if this was the rounding was off. So these are also your numbers of degrees earned in 1990. So let's make our circle. We're going to start by going by quarters. Okay, anybody want to tell me where to do the first one? It's a good starting place. How should I get this to my pie graph? Nick, where'd you start? Yeah, how should I start? Okay, because that's real close to 25, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if you come here and you're just real, real close to 25, this has one, if you want to keep track, this has one left over. So I have to say 24% associates. Be careful how you abbreviate that one. Okay, another one. What's another one I would use? Oh, you got my humor, girls. Good. 54 is close to 50. So I'm going to come down here and be a little bit more than 50. So this whole thing in here is 54% bachelor's. These are the highest degrees attained. So remember, the other one was a little bit less than 50, so that means the master's and the doctorate should probably be a little bit more. So now I gotta go 5 and 17. So if I went in 4 in here, and I went 1 up there, there's a change of like 3. So I have about 22 to work with. So I'm just gonna make this guy be 5. And 17% the master's. Is it reasonable? Is my 17% smaller than my 24? Is my 5 the smallest by far? My 54 the largest by far? Is it past the halfway mark? That's what we're looking for. But it looks aesthetically correct. I'm not going to measure by angles or anything like that, but I'm going to eyeball it to see if you're in the ballpark. So we good here? So Danny, I'm Jaden. How's it going there? So you want to put your phone away and work on these? I don't want phones out when we're working. Not at all. All right. Next graph. This is probably a graph that you haven't seen before. If you look in your book on page 59, this is a Pareto graph. A Pareto graph. A Pareto graph is for qualitative data. If you look at the graph on page 59, the x-axis is what kind of data entry is the x-axis? Nominal ordinal integral ratio. Now look in your book on page 59. Look at that graph. Look at the x-axis on the bottom. What kind of data is that? Good.
Nominal.
Nominal. Good. Because these guys are just the names of different things. They're nominal. This is qualitative data. This is a way to display your qualitative data. Your y-axis has got to be numbers, got to be frequency. We've got to count something to get it on a graph, right? So what we do here, and this is really, really important that you get this. It's for qualitative data. Your x-axis is nominal. Your bars do not touch. There are gaps between your bars because your x-axis has no continuity. There's no continuity between those names. So those bars do not touch. The y-axis is generally your frequency. Every once in a while, it is your relative, but not too often. The most important part is that your bars are positioned in decreasing order, from highest to lowest. So what does that do for somebody? It makes their eyes look at that graph. So if we're putting in, and I'm going to have you use your book to reference this. If we're putting in, here is a retail industry. They've been losing billions of dollars. They lost $34.5 billion in inventory shrinkage. That results in all these things that cause their inventory to shrink. They want to address the one that's causing them to lose the most, don't they? So if we make this graph, and you make your graph here, okay, here's the employee theft. That's the biggest one. 15. So if we make a bar with 15, then their next one was shoplifting, skip a space, and your shoplifting is 12 something, see it? And then the next one is administrative error, and administrative error is 4.2. Do you see it coming down? Then vendor fraud, that's in here, and then lastly, unknown. So if I'm the manager of this place, I'm the CEO, I'm like, we're losing $34.5 billion. Where's my money? Why am I losing all this money in 1 year? I want to look at that highest bar, don't I? I don't care about the vendor fraud as much. I'll take care of that when I have time. But I want to hit this one, employee theft. That's causing me to lose $15.1 billion a year. That's a heck of a lot of money that my employees are stealing from me. So it kind of gives you the order, highest to lowest. I do care about these, don't get me wrong, I will, but that one is catching my eye. Notice there's no gaps here because there's no continuity. These are nominal measurements. It is our one graph that helps us graph qualitative data.
I have to count my frequency. That's where the amount of money comes in. That's my frequency. My y-axis has to be a frequency. So your bars are going to go from highest to lowest. It's kind of nice. All right, so let's try one together. The other way around. All right, so we're the Better Business Bureau, and we receive complaints from customers. The Better Business Bureau receives a lot of complaints. So in a recent year, we had 14-something complaints from an auto repair, 85, 68 complaints from insurance company, blah, 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 complaints about telephone companies, complaints about travel agencies. I want to put this in a graph. Now, all my auto repair, my insurance companies, they're nominal measurements. They're qualitative data. So what I can do is make a Pareto graph. And my Pareto is going to go from highest to lowest. And it'll kind of catch my eye to see where this is going. So let's do this together, and then we'll call it a day. This is my Better Business Bureau. Okay. These are my categories. These are my complaints. This is my frequency. Just if they give you numbers, just use a frequency. Don't do a relative, unless it specifically tells you. So now I got to get these in highest to lowest order. Which one has the highest complaints? Telephone. So this is going to be my telephone company. Notice in the graph there's no breaks in the x-axis either because there's no continuity, there's no numbers down there. So I skip a space. Who has my next one? Auto repair. What's next? Insurance. Then mortgage. Good. That's all you have to do. Then one more, travel agencies. Now my y-axis is my frequency. It has to go from 0 to this highest, to 15, almost 16. Let's go to like 16,000. So judge how you can do this. Can I go by 5,000s? That'll only give me 3 marks. Maybe I want to go by 3,000s. That'll give me 5 marks or 6 marks. So if I say 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, and a little bit more in thousands. And then you're going to make your bar. So your telephone company is a little bit more than 15. Do not let them touch. Your auto repair is 14. A little high, higher than, like a little high, but not as high. Our insurance companies are about 8,000, somewhere in the 8,000 area. And then 6,000 something, these are kind of close. And then 5,000 something. So do you see the look of it? All these complaints, if I'm the Better Business Bureau and I'm supposed to make sure these businesses are running well, and I've got complaints, don't I want to kind of look at the one I'm getting the complaints the most about? Something's going on with the telephone industry. I gotta get a hold of this. I gotta contact them, see what's going on. I'd maybe put some more rules in there for them. Auto repairs, that's another one. How many of you have taken your cars to get repaired? And one guy will tell you, this is wrong. Someone else will tell you, that is wrong. They replace something and say, well, that doesn't really it, we'll try this. Cost you a fortune coming out of an auto repair shop. So maybe they need controls on this. Maybe they need to monitor this. Yeah, they care about these things over here, travel agencies, but for them, they want to hit their biggest ones first. You're the customer. They don't want you making all those, having all those problems with those companies. So the Pareto chart is one of those charts that allows them to look at nominal data, qualitative data, and somehow organize it. Good? Not a bad one. An easy one. All right. Monday we'll probably finish this little unit up on graphs. I know it's not a pleasant unit, but it does have a lot of different graphs.